My name is Robert McKee. I'm a third year graduate student in the microbiology and immunology department in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. So I study the bacterial pathogen Clostridium difficile. It's commonly referred to as C. diff. So it's a bacterial pathogen that can cause a disease usually after someone undergoes antibiotic treatment. So the antibiotics mess with the gut bacteria and allow C. diff to grow and cause disease in people. The disease is pretty bad. It's a diarrheal disease that can cause really severe colitis, and it can lead to death in very severe cases. But the most important factor is that antibiotic treatment is what causes this. So we want to know sort of what factors C. difficile uses to colonize the host when those bacteria are not around. And so I study pili, which are a structure on the outside of the bacterium that allow it to attach to surfaces and also move along them. So now I have some tissue on a plate that I can see whether the bacteria can attach to it and then see if we can translate that to sort of the disease. Yeah, there's a lot of misinformation about a lot of things, you know, sort of how science, you know, comes to breakthroughs. You know, people think, well, everyone has to be trying to find a vaccine immediately, but you won't know what's going to be useful for a vaccine if you don't know sort of what components of the organism are helping it to cause disease. So a lot of the vaccines we've had for other bacterial diseases have been focused on, you know, toxins and stuff. So you have to know what those are before you can actually include them in a vaccine. So I guess, yeah, the main overarching goal is to figure out sort of, you know, what factor C. diff is using to colonize the intestine of the host. So that's the sort of the broad goal. I mean, eventually, if we found some interesting things, that would maybe move towards sort of a therapeutic option, but that's sort of very far in the future. Continue to be curious. Don't ask questions. Don't just accept something because you read it somewhere. You know, go ask, like, be critical of that and say, like, well, is that really true? How do we know that that's the truth? And I think that you can do a lot of things with that sort of thinking. It doesn't even necessarily have to be science, but I think that that's something that you can do a lot of things with. Discouraged to ask questions. You have to sort of question, you know, like, why are they not wanting to ask questions? What's there to hide? So I think that sort of, you know, open criticism of things is actually a really good thing to have in general.